we're going to build an incredibly powerful AI that runs locally on your phone.
Hey Siri, set a 30-minute timer.
Hey guys, welcome back to Tenishare AI's channel. Do you use Siri like the beginning of the video? I guess so. Siri is Apple's ubiquitous virtual assistant, but it seems that it is not that powerful in daily life. In an era where AI chatbots and large language models are popular, Siri seems to have fallen far behind its competitors. Is it time for Apple to kill Siri? Wait, things may turn around. Apple's cooperation with OpenAI may make a difference. What happens when Apple combine the powerful ChatGPT with Siri? In today's video, we will explore the story of Siri in depth and what Siri AI will be like. First, let's look back at the birth of Siri.
Robert Jordan, a second semester junior, requesting a second extension on his term paper. And your mother reminding you about your father.
Surprise birthday party next Sunday.
Today you have a faculty lunch at 12 o'clock. You need to take Kathy to the airport by 2. You have a lecture at 4:15 on deforestation in the...
This video, known as Knowledge Navigator, inspired developers Adam Chayer, Dag Kitlaus, and Tom Grubber, who began AI research on virtual assistants. In February 2010, Kitlaus launched Siri as an app on Apple's App Store, which intrigued Steve Jobs. A few weeks later, Apple acquired the startup and then Siri was born. In 2011, Siri Beta was released, marking a new era in human-computer interaction. In Apple's philosophy, Siri isn't just a tool, it's your intelligent assistant that can help you with a variety of tasks. But over time, Siri seems to have gotten dumber. Many users would agree that Siri's functionality has changed very little over the past few years. In many cases, Siri either gets it wrong, doesn't know the answer, or can't verbalize it. On the contrary, AI chatbot that appeared in the last 2 years, such as OpenAI ChatGPT, Amazon Alexa, Microsoft Cortana, they are not only smarter and able to help you in your work, but also able to manipulate your smart home in daily life. Josh Johnson said, "I honestly think Apple should kill the Siri brand. I'm not sure it can recover from the universal understanding that it's just not good, but Siri is so ingrained in Apple's ecosystem that dropping it could alienate existing users who are already accustomed to the name and features. So it doesn't seem like Apple is going to abandon Siri, but rather provide Siri with new generative AI features that will help users in their daily lives." Rumor said that Apple is planning to overhaul Siri using LLM to make it the ultimate virtual assistant. Improvements could come in the form of better natural conversation features and improved user personalization. The new features are expected to work across devices, so Siri may be able to retain conversational information from one device to another. According to Mark Gurman, one of the specific features Apple is working on is improving Siri's interaction with the Messages app, which would allow Siri to more effectively auto-complete sentences and answer complex questions. We'll likely see this update at WWDC 24 in June. However, Apple isn't planning to launch its own generative AI chatbot at the event. While Apple has had discussions with companies like Google, OpenAI, and Baidu about generative AI partnerships. According to Gurman, Apple's first set of new AI features in iOS 18 will be completely independent of cloud servers. It seems like Siri AI, or Siri 2.0, is really coming. Are you looking forward to it? Let me know what you think in the comments section. So that's it for today's video. Don't forget to like and subscribe. See you next time.